department is pretty annoyed with me since I did the muffler delete on this car. The cold start is like, I mean, this is with the windows up. Anyways, for the first like 30 seconds, it's just like obnoxiously breathy and loud and yeah. Alrighty, I know what you guys are thinking. Hey, asshole, where's that video of Quinn's 300 horsepower turbo Miata? Well, see, we came up here to record the video. We came up here to kind of get a game plan and then go on the streets, get a lot of footage, get a lot of rolling shots, get some pulls, get whatever we can get. Yeah, we just,
It's just going?
Well, you got a couple different times. So.
Wait, okay.
All right. Boy.
Ready?
Isn't he always in a certain... Boy. Oh my God. Boy.
It's already recording, I don't have to man the
car.
We kinda just sat up here and goofed off. Sorry I don't have that video for you guys. So I'm gonna make this video in place of it. This is the 5 things I hate about my Miata. Now everybody's making these videos. TJ Hunt keeps making them about everything. I hate BRZ, I hate 350Z, I hate Miata, it's not even mine. No offense, I'm just playing around. Just playing, just having a little fun. The thing is, the things that TJ and Calvin that you guys mentioned about the Miata, I don't feel like they're real issues. The only thing that can be even close to a legitimate issue is the window falling out of the soft top, because it's just a very common thing. This soft top is the original soft top. I don't know how the fuck it's in such good condition. It's 16. Almost 17 years old now. So let's go over the 5 things I hate about my Miata. Alright, so the first thing I hate about my Miata, and this is not a mechanical thing, this is just a visual thing, is the lights. The second generation Miatas, the only thing I like about the look of them is the ass. I love the bigger fender hump things, and it's got a good looking ass. But the front, it looks like, I don't know, it looks like some sad ass duck or something. But I'm getting used to it. So these lights are foggy as hell. And I know, I could just treat them. I could just scrub all the shit off. Trust me, I do it probably about once every 2 fucking weeks, and I hate doing it. So for the last month or so, I've just given up. I'm not doing it anymore because it's not, sometimes I can barely see at night, but I am tired of just, I'm so tired of that. So I found this whole headlight housing online for a couple hundred bucks, a set of them, and they're glass, and they'll never fog up again. So that's the number one, the first thing that I hate about my Miata. All right, this is the second thing that I hate about my Miata. Whenever I want to put the top down, which is not very often, whenever I want to put the top down, if there is anything back here on this cargo shelf or to the sides, which you can't see if there's anything back there. The only way you can tell is if you reach your hand in that corner, and if there's anything back there, that's where basically the hinges and all, like the working mechanism on the side of the sides of the tops, that's where it all stores down when it folds down. So nothing can be there, and if it's there, it'll either get crushed, get like sheared in half, or the tops just won't go down, and you'll get very frustrated. That's something I kind of hate. All right, this is the third thing that kind of irritates me. This is a very recent issue. So this is my CB antenna. None of you youngins know what the fuck this is, but I basically use it to talk to your mom all the time. So my issue with this right now, I love the CB antenna. I love the CB radio. I don't love how loose that is. That's so loose. That is so loose. It's not gonna fall off because there's a bolt going under this magnet into this top part, and that's tight. But the plastic bushing that held it tight in the base has worn out over the last 16 years and now is super wobbly. All right, here is the fourth thing I hate about my Miata. This is something that a lot of people can relate to, just with small cars in general. When you have a Miata, you will be going out into the parking lot, right? You know exactly where your car is at just because you're so in tune with yourself like that. You're walking around, you're like, wait a minute. Where the hell's my car? It was right there. Where is it at? And then you get closer and you're like, man, I don't know where my Miata's at. I'm freaking out. I think somebody stole it. I forget to lock my doors all the time. That's totally possible. And then you're about to just have a fucking heart attack. You're like, where the fuck is my car? And then all of a sudden, oh, it's right there on the other side of that Mini Cooper that was covering it up so damn well. All right. So this is the fifth thing that I hate about my fucking Miata. This is the worst thing, all right? This is something that if you work on your own car, you will have to do this. This is something that I plan to fix in the future, as in relocating the problem or the fuse box just entirely, like to anywhere else, because that would be infinitely easier. So where the fuses are for turn signals, windshield wipers, not your main, but all your little electrical stuff, is under the dash, right? A lot are under the dash. But say you take off this panel to get to the fucking fuses, yeah, that's your OBD2 port right there. That's not fuses. Fuses are like a foot past that, and then a foot up, and then through like a bunch of wires. I can't even find it right now. I can't even find it, and I know exactly where it's at. So this is how you change fuses or check fuses in the Miata. If you don't have the luxury of taking your steering wheel off, like a lot of times I do, in this car I don't, this is how you change your fuses. Just relax right here. Crack your back. Ow. Hit your head on the fucking steering wheel. Get up in there. This is how you change fuses. Yeah, so that's how you change fuses in the Miata. So those are the five things I hate about my Miata. I don't really hate anything about my Miata. Before I end this video, I want to address some of the things that TJ Hunt and Calvin Hunt, I assume they're married, I don't know. I'm gonna address some things that they said, probably everything. Number one, cup holders. I think you said something about cup holders. I'm pretty sure you did. The cup holders that go in the center console, that's not the cup holders. Those are not the cup holders for the Miata at all. Those are the amateur cup holders. Those are the factory ones. There's another place where you can put your drinks that makes it pretty much the best cup holder in the world. So right in between both of the seats, there's the center console, and then you have passenger seat, driver seat. This little gap right here on the seat, stick your drink right in there, it will never move, ever. Number two, the window. Just buy a new soft top, couple hundred bucks. I have one if you want it. Contact me and you might be able to obtain this soft top that is in great condition, glass window, yada yada. Number three. You said something, number three. Oh, number three, TJ. You said it's impossible to get sippy? Whatever the fuck that is, in a Miata. I assume you mean BJ or blowjob. Since my family watches this, I'm gonna say, I wouldn't know. I don't know. Oh, look at me. But I'm gonna say that I have a lot of people that I know for a fact have gotten or given sippy in a Miata. And where did you find that word? Who taught you sippy? Where did that come from? I'm very concerned for the vocabulary that's coming up nowadays. Number four. Oh, number four. Your hair getting messed up? Oh my God, your hair getting messed up. All right. I don't really care about my hair much. I know you do. That's cool. The thing about the soft top being down and screwing up your hair, on contrary to popular belief, the soft top being up or down is an option. You choose it. You can put it up if you want. Rumor has it, you may have to Google it. There may be a certain code you have to type in, but I have heard long, long ago, people would reach their arm back, grab the soft top, pull it up, latch two latches, roll the fucking windows up, and your hair's good. I'm just saying. Just saying. I only put the soft top down when I'm cruising at night, like 7 at night. On the sun, recording this video, I feel my face fucking sunburn right now. I hate it. I hate the sun. I hate it because I lived in Tucson, Arizona for a while, and that is the most sunniest bullshit crack whore fucking place in the world. Oh, okay, okay. Okay, motherfucker. I remember now. First thing, everybody has a Miata, yeah. There's a reason everybody has a fucking Miata, alright? If you want to build a project car, if you have this crazy vision like I do, I own three of these sons of bitches, alright? They are the perfect car. They're balanced perfect 50-50 weight distribution, alright? Front to back, perfect. So it's like you want to make this perfect art piece, which is your project car. You don't start with a piece of paper that already has shit drawn all over it. Like, you don't start with a piece of paper that's been used. You start with a perfect white blank canvas, or black, or gray, or beige, whatever the fuck canvas you can find. You start with a blank canvas. Miatas are a blank canvas. TJ, you said everything that that can be done has been done in Miatas. I'm gonna say it. I don't normally say this word. But boy, see, I don't say that word, all right? I'm gonna say my version. Motherfucker, are you serious? Everything has been done to these Miatas? Are you kidding me? I would say 10% of what can be done to Miatas hasn't even been touched, all right? I'm not saying there's 10% left, I'm saying 10% has almost been done. 90% hasn't even been thought of yet, all right? I have plans, not for this car in particular, but for the 92 and the 94 that I have. Five-cylinder Volvo engine swap, all right? I think there's a five-cylinder Saab swap. That's different. Volvo, all the way. Bagged Miata? Whoa. Everybody does bag Miata? No. No. They don't go to a junkyard. They don't go find a semi. They don't take the big fucking foot round bags off a semi and put them on a Miata. That's what I'm gonna do. Not to this one. I'm only pointing at this one because this is the only one I have right here, right now. I need something to point at. All right, I'm gonna end this video here because I'm getting a bit emotional over the Miata thing. Just because Miatas are like my bloodline, all right? I have 89 horsepower stock running through my veins. So that's my video for today. TJ Hunt, Calvin, any bro army people, if you watch this, don't hate, all right? This isn't a video for hate, it's just a video for fun. And if you start to hate, you can just suck my dick.